Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to this third day of the Odoo Experience 2018. Here at Odoo, we are striving for the simplicity on the other side of complexity. What does that mean? It means translating often very complex ideas in easy to grasp purpose. Products that anybody can understand and can use. That sounds simple. To achieve this kind of simplification, you have to go through very tough and often baffling labor. You have to think beyond beliefs, preconceived ideas, and prevailing opinions. It stands for iterative approach, often switching back between the fast lane and the inside lane. Indeed, very hard work. Yet, reaching that simplicity is most inspiring and very rewarding to us, to you, to your customers. This is precisely the job of the two people representing today's opening note. Please help me in giving a warm welcome to Laura Piraux and Fred Gilson. Yes.
Hi everyone, welcome to this last day of Odoo Experience, really intense this year. Good morning, Laura, how are you?
Good morning, Fred. Well, I'm a bit sad today.
Laura, ça ne va pas? Tu veux aller à la pompe? What's wrong today, Laura? You want to go to the gas station?
You know, it's already the last day of the Odoo Experience, so...
Oh yeah, I understand, but yeah, today... actually, there's a lot of people on this Friday morning. It's kind of impressive. Is it because of the title of this session, maybe? What do you think?
No idea. I don't know why there are so many people here today after the party from last night.
So, Laura, let's get serious. So, we have 20 minutes to shed some light on the future, on Odoo 13. So, Odoo 13... What is it going to be about, Laura?
Okay, so you know that at Odoo, we strive to save our users' time. So we think that our users should be able to focus on what brings value to their business, such as developing their products, trying to find new markets, or finding new ideas. And you don't make your business growing by encoding vendor bills the entire day or recording your employees' leaves. But that's sometimes that you have to do. So our goal at Odoo is to reduce the time that is spent on those activities so that you can really focus on what matters. But as you said, the subject of this talk is the future of Odoo. So what will come next to achieve that goal? First, you will be able to purchase more services directly from your Odoo database. That's what we call in-app purchase. And it will help you to save time because you will be able to integrate with third-party vendors and directly share the information with them. You will also save time because the payment is directly made from Odoo. So if you're okay, let's have a look at some of the services that we could offer with the in-app purchase in the future.
Sure, let's do it.
First, there is Odoo Bank. As you know, any business has to find some money to start or to grow. And it takes a lot of time to go to the bank and to ask for a loan. So in the future, we intend to offer loans directly from Odoo as an easy and fast way to get some cash.
So will I have like a credit card with Odoo on it?
No. So what you will have to do, that's much more simple than this. If you need some cash to be able to grow your business and you have some invoices on your Odoo database and you have some clients that have to pay you for those invoices, you will be able to use them as an asset, and we will directly give you the cash.
As simple as that.
It is.
Wow.
So you have probably... Thank you. You have also probably discovered the new OCR feature so that you can scan and have your vendor bills directly recorded in the systems. But there are many other documents that you have to record in Odoo, and that's taking a lot of time, and that's really boring tasks. So in the future, there will be other documents that you will be able to scan and directly record in your Odoo database, such as the expenses and the business cards. I know that you've collected a lot of business cards during
your
experience.
Yes, indeed, I did, with a lot of feedback from all the community and partners. So you mean I'll be able to connect my printer on my computer and directly scan all my business cards, and all the leads, all the contacts in my system will be generated.
Yes, you got it, Fred.
Wow. I wanna hear you say it. Wow. Ah.
Okay, another pain point for a company can be to find an accountant that is ready to work with your accounting solution. With Odoo, we will give you some help so that you can find a suitable accountant for you that will directly work on Odoo, that will know how to use Odoo. And you will save time but also money, because you won't have to transfer your accounting data from Odoo to the other accounting software. Everything will be centralized and you will already have someone who knows the system and who can use it. I've mainly explained some services that are interesting for the administrative and the financial departments. But for the human resources too, it can be really interesting to have some services directly through Odoo. Let's take an example. You could just post one job ad on a recruitment website in one click and post the ad on websites such as Monster and Indeed, for example. And you know that we are recruiting a lot of people, so I think that our HR department will be really happy with that.
Indeed.
Okay, so another big novelty for the Odoo experience this year was the new Odoo IoT Box. That's a device that allows you to connect hardware to your Odoo database. And this has many possibilities. For example, you could track your stock of consumable products by linking a scale or probe to your stock so that you exactly know how much you have left, and you can also trigger the reordering process automatically. Another example would be to link dash buttons to Odoo so that your employees can just in one click reorder some products.
So just like Amazon products with the dash button to reorder, will it work like that?
Exactly, and at Odoo we will never run out of coffee anymore.
I don't like coffee, but anyway.
IoT is also an interesting technology for monitoring tools. So if you are able to connect monitoring tools to your machines and to your equipment, you can know the status of that equipment at any moment. And you can also make sure that there is no downtime for these machines. It's also a good technology for position tracking. So you could think of track the position of your stock. For example, a pallet, if you have a very big warehouse that is a bit messy, you could find it easily. Or the position of your truck to know exactly when your stock will arrive in the warehouse. The position of your cars also, or of any valuable materials in the company, so that you make sure that it doesn't get lost or stolen.
And will it work with my employees too?
Yeah. So you can also link the IoT to a badging system so that you can record the attendances of your employees, but also of participants to an event like the Odoo experience. Okay, so that's it for me. So now it's your turn to show me what you have on your side, Fred.
Okay, let's go ahead. Thank you, Laura. Of course, improving Odoo is not only about adding integration with third-party services or integrating the system with machines. It's also improving the native features of the system. And for the year to come, we'd like to adopt a new strategy to improve the product, because we've got the feeling that now we have a mature product. We've got this feeling, no more big revamp in this new Odoo 12 version. And actually, the way we're going to improve the native features will be industry-focused. If we take a look at the adoption curve of Odoo, we got the feeling that we're getting there. We are taking the mass market. But the way we do it is actually different than addressing early adopters. So here on this curve, you see the two different targets. And the way we address people from the business is totally different than the early adopters. The early adopters, they are looking for features. The people from the business, they are looking for ready-to-use solutions. And to do so, we need to improve both our marketing and our product, industry per industry. In terms of marketing, we need industry dedicated pages on Odoo.com to explain people how Odoo can help them out in their business. In terms of product, we need to improve the basic features so that any kind of industry can easily start with Odoo without having to install custom modules and so on. So first, let's take a look at the industry pages. Here is just an example of what it could be for the automotive industry. On those pages published on our website, we'll have all the features needed by such industry, the benefits of using Odoo, some customer references. It's really important to convince your customer to join us. A starting link to start Odoo in a pre-configured system with all the needed application in the industry, plus adapted demo data.
So Fred, you mean that if I'm a real estate agent, for example,
yes.
I go on Odoo website,
yes.
I search for my industry, and then in one click, I have a package with all the features I need for my own business.
Yes, you won't have to set up everything from scratch. Everything will be done in just one click. Isn't that cool?
Super cool.
And of course, this will not only help the SaaS adoption, it will help all the community, because then it will drag many more customers than what we are doing today. So, yeah, you might wonder, and what about the features? What are you going to add in this standard version? So, just some examples. It's not yet decided in all industries, and it's going to be a collaborative work with the community, the partners, the consultants, and so on. Some examples. Let's talk about the retail industry. In the retail industry, and more especially in the e-commerce, there's still some missing tools, like an integration with Amazon, a better product search with several levels menu, a better integration with social media, especially to manage the after sales. You deliver product to the customers, you want to easily reach out with them in order to tell them, okay, yeah, your package is ready. You can do it on Facebook, WhatsApp, and so on and so on. So there are many improvements to do so in order to improve the after sales. A good one, the maintenance, the customer maintenance. You imagine you are repairing a heating system at the customer, and you want to show up with an easy-to-use maintenance sheet on tablet that you can easily, where you can easily pick up the products to repair, write down some explanation about what you did, and make the customer sign. So it's actually a better integration of existing modules that we already have in Odoo, the project management, the stock with the products, and the e-signature application. So there are a lot of things to do to improve the way we manage the maintenance at the customer side, so not within my company. Let's move on. I really like that one. The fashion industry. The fashion industry, what do they need? And so really, it's a must-have in this industry. When you manage the orders, the purchase orders, the sales orders, you need an easy tool to easily enter the quantity per kind of product. Here we have a specific model of shoes with different sizes and colors. With in the tab, here a matrix, you can easily enter the quantity per combination, and bam, all this, the lines in the sales order are automatically generated. It's the kind of tool people need in that industry, and yeah, it matters to us to have this in the standard.
And I think we will need that too for Odoo,
yes.
For the shoes that we are selling.
Worried about the Odoo shoes here. Okay, so the shop is still open. Don't forget before leaving today. NGOs. I really like that example because it's a personal experience. NGOs. Here is one example of a missing feature. Of course, we have a couple of things to add for NGOs, but this is based on an experience I had with a customer a few years ago. It was an American-based NGO, great people, very smart, and they wanted to to change their life with an easy system to manage, collect donations. They had a couple of systems. The system was a nightmare. They wanted something simple. And we were just at a finger of changing their life. And you know, we are struggling with just one thing. The name of the page on the e-commerce. They told me, come on, Fred, are you serious? Do you really think that our people will support children in a shop? Of course not. It's not a shop. We are not selling children. We are not selling slaves. We are supporting them. I told myself, yes, of course. Am I stupid or what? And the only missing thing was the ability to customize URLs. I will have my revenge in a few months from now. This will be over, and I will personally contact them to tell, yeah, now you can finally manage this in Odoo. You can finally rename your URLs. Hospitality, the hotels. An easy way to manage bookings, to manage availabilities, check-in, check-out. We have already a couple of existing tools in the solution that help you do that with the project management, for instance, the agenda, the calendar. But it's not enough. We need to move forward in terms of resource management here in the example of hotels. So here are a couple of examples. We have many others in mind. And the goal, moving forward, will actually start this next Monday, is to deliver one new industry every month. So, of course, it's not only something we'll do only at Odoo. We'd like to collaborate with the community. And that's why we'll create collaborative documents that we'll share on the internet. And I hope that you guys will help us out in this new mission.
At Odoo, we spend a lot of time to save our users' time. We want them to be able to focus on what brings value to their business. And for Odoo version 13, we will focus on those three main points to achieve that goal. So first, offer services directly integrated into the Odoo database with the in-app purchase modules. Then we will be able to connect more devices to the Odoo database with the IoT box. And then we will offer packages that are already tailored for specific industries.
Thank you very much, Laura. And also one thing, that's actually the things that we're going to add to our development process. But we'll go on existing aspects. The localizations as well won't be forget. We'll, of course, continue the work we are doing with the community to improve such aspects in the solution. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Please bear with us. If that wasn't exciting, please bear with us a second while the customer and the partner is installing the infrastructure. I'm particularly glad to welcome today the project that will be displayed as a success story. It is a true success story. First of all, I want to thank the customer, Puili Oy, Finnish retail company, very innovative. And I want to extend a special welcome to Johanna Hietali, the IT manager of Puili Oy, Jarno Kumulainen, IT manager of Puili Oy as well. This particular success story will be introduced by Marco Haponen, the partner and the founder of Sprint IT, the partner that enabled this true story to become successful, to Esa Hapa Aho, the project manager, Puili Oy and Sprint IT, and Vitali Eremev, Ventatech, responsible for the web application from the smartphone. Please help me in welcoming these gentlemen.
Thanks, Johan, and good morning to everyone. What a great Odoo experience we have had here. This is my first time, and I've really enjoyed the feeling, and especially the party last night. In fact, when this case Puuilo happened, I was actually working as a CIO for that company, helping them to find the very best ICT solutions for their business. That's why this story is very, very familiar to me. It was early summer 2015, I visited the CEO of Puuilo, Markku Tuomaala, first time. He needed some help to maybe improve webshop or logistics or something. But when figuring out the real needs and pains of Puuilo, it showed up that actually all the ICT systems had to be rebuilt from very scratch. The company had grown very, very fast during past 10 years, and nobody had had time to figure out the real IT needs and solutions. Actually, just 20 years before that, they were selling wooden toys at open air marketplaces, and now they were running a huge chain of warehouses. It's very typical situation at enterprises in Finland, no time for IT, and I assume that this is very existing picture also globally. Actually, that was the very beginning of the process that a few months later became a success story for Odoo and Sprint IT. But of course, we didn't know that at that time. Because first we had to detect the main pain points at Puuilo. All the products and business data was fragmented all over the company, mostly in Excel sheets, in everyone's personal hard drives. All that info was maintained and updated manually, also to POS and webshop. There were no way to get up-to-date stock data or inventory value, and if you got some sales reports, you couldn't trust on them, and you had to check everything manually. But nevertheless, there were 13 IT vendors and 11 servers all over the Finland. Tons of overlapping processes and tasks going on. Those were the pain points. Then the needs for Puuilo at that time. They were quite obvious. All the product and business data has to be maintained in one place with easy access for everyone and every system that needs it. Especially prices must be absolutely right in all the sales channels. At that time, it was like that. Also, the stock data has to be available. It's quite difficult to sell products in webshops if you don't even know if we have those products on stock. And also, we had to have a solid IT strategy and overall ICT architecture. No more just IT procurements just to fulfill some special needs. That evaluation process showed clearly Puila need, really need to renew the way of working and all the IT systems to handle the change. 120,000 products, almost 20 warehouses, worth 10 million euros importing goods directly from China, and annual turnover over almost 100 million euros. It was totally impossible to manage that all manually anymore. Well, this was the result we were figuring out. We need an ERP with some functionalities. We need very, very good product information management system. And of course, when these are okay, then we need some supporting systems. Those ERP and PIM, they are the heart of Puilo's new system. And then some core systems like POS, webshop, business intelligence, financial things, and so on, and some supporting things. This was the result. We didn't know at that time, is it possible, who could do it, who could possibly had a system to build something like this, but this was the need. Then in Puilo, we did our best to find the solutions to fulfill these needs. We were briefing over 50 different systems or companies. We calculated the overall costs in next 3 to 10 years, checked the background, reliability and reference cases of different systems. And then we got near and near, and at last we decided the system will be Odoo. Thank you. And some integrations as well. In my point of view, the lesson of Puilo case story clearly points out that Odoo is a full-blooded major system and totally competitive with the old school systems like SAP, Dynamics Family, Digia Enterprise or NetSuite. And Odoo is totally capable even to win the race, although when participating, it's ranked as an outsider. It also changed my way to think about ERP. I have always been, all my life, all my career, been an IBM and Microsoft guy. But now, because of this competition, for this case, I'm working to Sprint IT and Odoo. I will soon tell you more about benefits that new system gave to Puilo. But before that, please welcome my dear colleague, Marco.
Thank you, Esa. Thank you, and I'm glad to see all of you here today. I'm going to walk you through with a couple of facts and figures from the project. As Esa told, the end result was building up the ERP for Puilo based on the Odoo. And when we started the project, we were starting with Odoo 9. And currently, while we're speaking, we are just making the upgrades towards 11. And based on the what we've seen this week here, we're probably going to change the plan and go directly to 12. But that still remains to be seen. But that's quite probable that we will choose that option. We need also some other softwares, as Esa told, on top of the Odoo. So here you can see the basically the full scope of the core processes for Puilo. If we start from the critical part from the any retail business, it's the master data and especially the product data. And as you could see from Esa's presentation, main solution for the product information management is Akeneo, open source PIM system. And that's where the life cycle of any product we will start from. It will be created there. It will be enriched with the data which is needed in the web shop, point of sales, and also in Odoo. We have the integrations towards the campaign and marketing material tool, which is Adobe InDesign. And basically, this is used also for sending out the marketing campaigns and material to basically all households in Finland. As you can see from the picture, Puuilo is a real multi-channel retail company. So the sales are taking place not only in two web shops, one in Finland and one in Sweden, but also in the point of sales, and then also in the Odoo backend, where the some of the B2B sales is created directly in the Odoo. If you go further to right, the all purchasing processes are included in Odoo. As I mentioned, all the imports from China, Europe, Netherlands, the domestic Finnish suppliers, everything is covered with the Odoo purchasing. The purchasing is linked to the major domestic suppliers. So basically, the purchasing process and the goods receipt process is pretty much automated for the majority of the goods flows. And once we receive the goods to the shops and the warehouses, we start using the Odoo warehousing applications. It's basically covering all the goods flows, including inbound goods movements from the suppliers, all the internal transports between the shops and the main warehouse. And all of these processes are basically supported by the mobile app called Winter, which we're going to present to you in a couple of minutes. And in the warehousing area, there is an integration towards the third-party logistic companies. It's done via Unifound Connector, which is a pretty common integration platform in the Scandinavia. So that enables us to use basically any important logistic service providers. And for example, typical example is to deliver the web shop parcels to the end customers. The process basically ends to cash in the sales, and that happens in the invoicing and accounting. So basically, there is a full-blown account receivable features, including invoicing, reporting, included in Odoo. And the data is then distributed to financial systems where the bookkeeping is taking place, and also to Click BI management information reporting system, which is mainly used for providing the management the daily KPIs like sales per shop by product categories and so forth. But also actually Odoo is pretty much able to do the same thing. And but that's more used by the actual end users on the daily operations. So if you have a quick look into the volumes, so what's happening in the business on daily and monthly and even yearly basis, you can see that there's quite a lot of traffic and data flowing in and out from the system. That's due to the fact that the shops are basically open 7 days a week. The web shop is, of course, 24/7. They're all together currently 30 warehouses in Puuilo. We started somewhere from 16 warehouses, so during the course of the couple of last years, the business has basically doubled. And of course, that's partially due to the fact that Odoo and the other solutions what we've selected are enabling this kind of fast growth for the company. The database size is 200 gigabytes currently. Users are concurrent users currently around 220, 50 on the peak hours during the afternoon. Altogether, 350 users in the system. Stock locations, 5,000. Stock locations are used for in the shops and, of course, in the main warehouse where the pallet places and the stock bins are described as Odoo stock locations. Number of invoices per month, 14,000 for B2B clients. Stock moves per day, so every day, 50,000 stock moves minimum. And in some peak days in campaign situation, it's definitely even more. Active products currently around 60,000. And so these are the numbers currently. Having all of this, we definitely face some challenges as well. If you think about the typical use case for Puilo, you can see a couple of them here. One of the requirements were to enable creation of purchase order lines with hundreds of lines within a minute. And similarly, the same purchase order needed to be received to stock very quickly and fluently. Another use case could be that you want to see your available stock on your own shop for a certain supplier in a couple of seconds. It didn't happen in an out-of-the-box solution, so we need to figure out how to do that. And then, for example, some of the sales managers in the shops would like to see the last 3 months' sales per product category. Here a couple of practical examples what we needed to get out of the system. And of course, on top of this, if you think about 250, 220 concurrent users in the system, having the peak hour in the shops, rush hours in the Friday afternoon, everything have to work smoothly without any delays and so forth. So the system have to be super fast. So how to do that? First of all, you have to have state-of-the-art technology behind the bonnet. So all the servers need to have the CPUs, disk and memory, which are the latest technology. Also the data lines within the shop itself, the Wi-Fi lines, and the connections from the shop to the actual server servers, they needed to be high speed. Also, the hardware like PCs, laptops, mobile phones even, and then the industrial scanners, which we're gonna see soon here, they needed to be the best available. Then one, in a way, funny thing what we discovered during the journey was that we actually found out that by decreasing the number of CPUs, virtual CPUs in the server, we increased the performance considerably. That's due to the fact that the virtualization layer need to compare with the actual hardware, which is in the actual server side. So by decreasing the CPUs, we gained some speed to the system. We did a lot of code analysis. We used tools like PyFlame and PgBatches to find the bottlenecks in the processes. And those were very, very good tools. We could quite quickly get into the actual root causes of the slownesses in the system. And we did some workouts related to the Postgres tuning. Just to mention a few, you can see on the right side of the screen. It's about memory settings, for example, and making the auto vacuuming of the database taking place automatically. Related to the reports, we by using the Postgres materialized views, we could decrease the time of getting, and for example, a point of sales report. We decrease the time to get the report from 200 seconds. To 6 seconds. And I would like to thank the Odoo team to support us in one specific case, especially it was the negative quants or negative stocks in general. That caused some trouble to us during the implementation stages. as the system was, especially the point of sales, was generating some negative stocks into the system, and that's caused some slowness in the other goods movements in the and stock moves in the system. But Odoo provided a pretty neat scripts to us, which we could deal with this issue. And then what you need to do, definitely, in such an environment as this, you need to have some kind of facts what's happening in your system. So this is the tool what we're using currently in order to see what the servers and the databases, so how they are, what's the utilizations in the different parts of the system. So we're using Zubix for that. The good things with Zubix is that you can also have the kind of dashboard views where you can, with the one view, see the critical things, what are happening in the system. You can also trigger alerts if needed. And the other good thing with the Zubix is that you can actually go to the very detailed level of monitoring of your system. For example, checking the database level deadlocks even. So it can go dig down to the very details of the Odoo database processes as well. Okay, and at this point, I want to thank you, and I will hand over the stage back to Esa, who is talking about the benefits gained. Thanks.
Hello again. I think we are running out of time soon. I will very quickly go through a few benefits Odoo has given to Puuilo. It took 9 months to define the needs and select the vendors, but then only 8 months to build all the systems. So altogether, in 17 months from the very first meeting with CEO of Puuilo, all the old systems were gone, and Odoo was there controlling the business and the other systems. And during that period, 0 hours of sales breaks during the project. I think that was quite amazing. Of course, there are those three words really meant us a lot: community, modularity, integrations. A community made it possible to use some modules some of you have made for us. Multiple EAN codes, invoice merging module. Thank you for your help. That modularity makes it also possible to launch the system in phases. We had no big bang problems, and also we could see all the time something is happening, and it was also make much easier at Puuilo to pay those huge bills those Sprint ID guys were sending all the time for us, because something was really ready at the time. Also those integrations, a lot of integrations, we are not using the Odoo POS or WebShop, but it's a question of life cycle. Life cycle, POS and e-com system has to be replaced much more often than ERP or PIM system. That's the reason why we used a lot of integrations and different systems. Puuilo is growing fast, and it has been very easy to implement new warehouses and new business even to other countries during these years. Then a few words about the business benefits. They are quite clear. 3 years ago, there were thousands of Excel sheets to manage the data. Now, everything, all the product data is in Odoo. Easy to achieve, easy to implement. Also, in our webshop, we now know if the product is available or not, because Odoo knows it and tells to webshop, and it makes the product owners in Puuilo very happy. and all the sales reports are in real time. Three years ago, they were calculated once a month, and the inventory value we get once a year. Now they are all real time in order. Of course, there are plenty of those benefits Odoo has been able to give, but now the last, but not the least, a benefit, the handheld devices. Please welcome Mr. Vidal.
It's better? Okay, thanks. So, and in this project, our company were responsible for the mobile part of the implementation. So the goal was to integrate barcode scanners and connect it to the Odoo ERP to make it possible to work more than 100 users with these scanners. So, to better understand what we have done, let's start from the requirements. So up to 200 mobile barcode terminals had to connect to Odoo across all offline stores through the mobile application. Users had to have access to a certain set of functions for managing inventory stock and needed to the ability to easily resupply products to be sure there was always enough products in stock. The solution must have intuitive interface and simple UI to reduce the number of errors that users could make during their daily work. So at that time, we already had the solution. It's a vendor application, formerly known like MRP Warehouse. And we decided to not reinvent the wheel and integrate this application, just slightly adjust. So because this application has a clear UI, big easy to click buttons, straightforward logic, it's fully customizable. So we can adjust interface by role, by business roles, by users, give any access right. It's a proven solution, so more than 1,000 mobile users around the world working on it. And it's support of Odoo community and Odoo enterprise, including just released Odoo 12. So if there are some customers here, you will receive an update next week. What we have done? So the new Pillar version, it's a branded version of the app with a Pillar logo. It gives access to product info, including images, product availability across all the shops, and forecasted quantity in specific location. It's one-click access to updating quantity on hand or making a procurement request for any product at any warehouse. So, but it's better to see, right? Right now, on the background, you will see the real copy of production database with 100,000 products loaded there and more than 10,000 locations. So it's a real production database, a copy of this. And the server is far, far away. It's not installed on my local machine. On front, you will see the mobile application where I mirror the screen. Here, it means I can click, and you will see everything that I will see here. So let's try to make inventory update. Yeah. So now I can scan. Here's the barcodes. So it's searching, and now we see the image, the EAN, the price, all that customer wanted to see on one single screen. Moreover, we can scroll down to see the items in all offline shops and make sure we can make a procurement request in the right place. So let's try to update quantity right now. So we have 17 in last stock. Clicking here. So there is no virtual keyboard, but you have one on the mobile phone. Let's update it to 75. I click in only hardware buttons. By the way, I prefer the hardware buttons. You can work in gloves, no problem. Click in OK and apply. Not in warehouse, in shops. So you can check the product, you can see the picture. So the quantity was updated, now it's 75. The same way we can make a procurement request right from this screen. I can choose another warehouse, for example. So I want to supply it to this one. 10, it's okay, I guess. So I'll click cancel. Just a second. So let's try it again. Yeah, it depends on your procurement request and procurement order. So it depends, do you need to produce this item or you need to resupply it or you need to make a real purchase order. So it will be it will be the decision of the manager then, so based on the rules. One minute. Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's cancel it. So same way we can scan any item in any location and make a procurement request or update quantity on hand. And if you need just to update, it's another application. Yeah, we are here. So if you need just to update, you have another function, so we can discuss it after the event because we have no time more. So now, let's summarize, just quickly summarize. So Piraux does all warehouse operations now using a barcode scanner only, no papers anymore. Around 150 scanners work at least 12 hours per day in 25 shops for the last year and a half. More than 100,000 lines per day are updated through this application every single day. Thank you.
Thank you, Vitaly. It was a great presentation. At this point, I would like to take the opportunity and thank you, Puilo team, Juhana, Jarmo. You've been a great professionals in the project. I want to thank the Expansa Venture Tech team, Vitaly, Oleg. Great job, great apps, and especially the best of the best teams, Sprint IT team. Thanks a lot for the support on the journey. Thank you all.
Thank you, Marco, Asa, and Vitaly for this wonderful customer success story and for sharing the details of how that success was brought to a conclusion. I invite Vincent, our R&D colleague, to discuss and express a long-awaited feature, the keyboard navigation.
Thank you very much.